Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. I'm very excited to announce that Abby FindReader 16 is now on my computer. This new version of Abby FindReader will allow participants to have access to a stronger OCR engine and a slew of PDF editing tools. This video is meant to serve as an overview as to some of the most common workflows that I personally work through when using Abby FindReader. So let's jump right in. I have launched Abby FindReader PDF. Now there's two main distinctions when launching Abby FindReader PDF. There is the PDF document side of the house where you can use this tool as a PDF editor. But what I want to show you is the OCR editor. Abby has one of the strongest OCR engines on the market and can really assist you with converting file types from, say, PDF to Word, or edit underlying text of a document and update language settings. Now, when I first launch the OCR editor, it's going to prompt me to open up a file, and I have a sample file that I am ready to open. And from there, the first step that Abby's actually going to do is it's going to perform OCR on all of the pages. Now, there's a couple of different distinctions that I would first like to point out. On the far left side of the screen, we have the thumbnail section. This is where you can see a snapshot of all of the different pages within your document. Then we have the image panel. This is the panel that displays the visual aspect of your PDF, and typically it matches directly what the file is. Then on the far right side of the screen, we have the text area of Abby, and this is where we can edit any of the underlying text of the program. So if for some reason the OCR is poor, or you needed to update a spelling mistake, or even add in information for acronyms, you would do that in the text panel. And then finally, we have a zoom panel on the very bottom of the screen, and this will update depending on where you are in the image panel. So if I wanted to take a closer look at, say, this top level heading of my document, I could simply move my cursor there in the image panel and then take a closer look in the zoomed in panel on the bottom. Now for me, I actually don't really care about the zoom panel, so I'm going to close it so I have a little more real estate here. Now, before I do anything, I like to adjust my settings. So for me personally, I'm going to take this document into a searchable PDF. So I need to adjust my PDF settings. Now, before we continue, please hit that like and subscribe button for more up-to-date technology and accessibility best practices. Now back to the video. So to do that, I'm going to select the Tools button and then select Options. Now this brings up the Options window where I can set a variety of settings. Let's select the General tab. And in here, we can choose when the OCR editor begins, or you can set up a scanning device to scan documents directly into Abby. Where I really want to spend most of my time is under Format Settings. Now, earlier when I mentioned I'm going to be exporting to PDF, this is where I'm going to select my document type. Now, you can adjust the settings for documents, spreadsheets, PowerPoints, text files, HTML, EPUBs. So for PDF, let's dive into the preferred settings when creating accessible files. The first thing I want to adjust is the image quality. Now, if you have a lot of images in your document, be sure to set custom. Since we're here, let's go ahead and update these. I want to change my color control from automatic to do not change image color. I don't want any quality loss on my file. Then I'm going to change the drop-down menu for quality to quality loss not allowed, and then select OK. There are additional settings that I have set that may not be relevant for you. For example, I like to create PDF UA documents, which does require OCR. Additionally, I have the checkbox selected, use MRC compression, which also requires OCR. And then I like to apply the Abby Precise Scan to smooth characters on page images. Now, what this does is it seems to make the font and the images just a bit crisper and easier to work with. Under searchable PDF settings, I like to have the text under the page image. However, you can adjust these settings for better results depending on the document you're working with. I'm going to have the option selected Create Bookmarks from Headings, Create PDF Tags, and I want to ensure that my fonts are embedded. Additionally, you can set metadata in this window by selecting Edit Metadata and applying the appropriate metadata. For this example, I'm going to say Abby Fine Reader example, and the subject, the author will be me, and the subject is going to be a overview, and select OK. Now there are other settings, but for now, I'm going to leave this as is. So when you first process a document into Abby, it's going to attempt to zone the file on its own. Now what we can do is adjust these zones to our liking. And the main differences between these zones are as follows. We have text, picture, table, and background image. Anything that we zone in this file is gonna be some of those things. So I'm going to zoom in just a little bit on page one, and we can determine that this font is properly tagged as a text zone. If I look at the image one over here, while it's not a direct image, for this particular example, I'm going to update the zone by right-clicking and select Change Area Type to Picture. From here, I'm simply going to review back and forth the image panel and the text panel to ensure that the OCR was properly selected. And I can determine this by the first paragraph. It looks pretty accurate. The text matches the accuracy of the image panel. Now you might be thinking, what if it didn't match up correctly? Well, there is a special OCR feature you can change, and it's right in the center of all of the options in the top menu bar. And this option currently is set to automatically choose between OCR and text from PDF, but if we wanted to, we could say, I want you to only OCR the text from the PDF, and that would be the use OCR option. Or if your PDF was created in another program and you're confident that the text is in there properly, you can use only text from PDF. Since I went ahead and updated this one zone to a picture, I need to re-recognize this page. Now, if I select the recognize button on the far top part of the page of the menu, it's gonna recognize the entire document. I want to simply recognize this single page by selecting recognize page. On page two, I'm going to delete all of the zones and we are going to rezone the page on our own. And to do this, I'm going to select the text tool and I can simply start drawing boxes around the content that I want to zone. After you place a zone on the page, you have additional settings that you can do, like copying the zone or changing different area parts. So using my mouse, I'm simply dragging the zones around my content. And once I'm finished grabbing all of the zones that I want to OCR, I'm going to select the button Recognize Page. And this will perform OCR on that page. Now, there are different styles you can adjust in the text panel. For example, this text Writing Helps You Learn has automatically been defined as a heading level 3. If I wanted to, I could change this to a different style of text. And this is very important if you are creating accessible documents because the exported file type will maintain these styles throughout. And then what we're going to do is simply go through the rest of these pages. Now, I like to delete the header and footer content, despite there being an option to keep it or remove it on export. I find that it's already a little bit buggy, and so I'm gonna simply go through the pages and validate that all of my zoning is correct. And anytime we adjust zones on a page, I need to re-recognize the page once again. So again, I am simply deleting the headers and footers, and we have just a few more minutes, we have just a few more pages to go. Now you might be thinking, Sean, why are you deleting these zones? Well, the reason is because they disrupt the reading flow when using assistive technology. So for me, it's very important to create accessible files, and one of the best practices for that is to simply delete content that ruins the flow of reading. I'm going to change this particular piece into a picture, and then let's keep deleting the headers and footers, just a couple more pages. And while I'm doing this, I'm visually scanning the page to ensure that the rest of the content is actually zoned. All right, so I deleted out all the zones I don't want, and we are going to export a completed PDF. So to do that, I'm going to ensure that I have exact copy selected, and then I'm going to select the Save as Searchable PDF. This is where you can change your export to a variety of different options. Searchable document, and I'm going to save my file, and it automatically opens within Adobe Acrobat. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to open up the tags panel, and we have a fantastic tags panel that is going to need some cleanup, but it's a great start. For example, I have some H1 tags that will need to be combined into a single tag. We have a figure tag that's going to need alternate text. But as we can see, our H2 tags are coming through. List elements, for the most part, are coming through properly. We have a heading 2, a heading 3. And all in all, the page looks really good, and all of the headings seem to have come through. Of course, we're going to need to adjust some of these. For example, this H5 tag doesn't make sense. It would probably be an H3 based on the other heading structure, but this gives us a fantastic starting point to begin to make this file accessible. Now, typically, I would take that Adobe Acrobat file and fully make it accessible to PDF UA and WCAG AA standards. For more videos that cover that important topic, please check out the description of this video and check out some of my other playlists. As always, I can be your personal accessibility expert. Thank you so much for watching today, and see you next time.